All right, so give some applause to Shiva.
Good. Cool. All right, so the previous talk had a lot of images, but my talk doesn't have a lot of images, but it will also have a lot of information, so I recommend you write it down or write down this URL at least so that you can visit the slides later on. You can refer them, all right? Or take a picture, yeah. Cool. Road to Mastering NativeScript UI. About me, I'm Shiva Prasad. You can tweet me at multishiv19. I'm a partner at NStudio, and I'm also a developer expert for NativeScript, and I'm also working as a software engineer for the Grandfather product at Bevy, New Zealand. And yeah, so let's get this started. So since this is a road to mastering NativeScript UI, I made this nice little road for you. So this is what we'll be talking about. First, we'll be talking about UI widgets, and then about layout containers and some do's and don'ts about layouts. And then we'll be talking about themes and animations. And so we should be going green, so I'll be using Tesla car. So I put that there. All right, let's first start with mastering UI widgets. So let's breathe here, take a moment and look at all the widgets here. I'll give you 5 seconds. Okay, so 5 seconds, done I guess. So there are 19 UI widgets in NativeScript. Don't worry, you don't have to memorize all of them. I'm not gonna ask that in the test at the end of this conference. I won't ask you like, oh, name all the UI widgets in the order that they appeared in my slide. I'm not gonna do something like that. But yeah, so there are so many UI widgets, and most of the UI widgets are pretty obvious. When you look at a button, okay, you know what a button is, right? So they're all named in a way that it's easy to figure out what they do. But when you want to master these UI widgets, let's see how you have to do that later on. And also, like, when you learn about the UI widgets, also learn about view and view base. They are in the API docs. So yeah, so if you want to master the UI widgets, there is no simple way to do it. Just go to the API docs, and that's where you can properly master NativeScript UI widgets. And for this, the best way to do is use NativeScript Playground. It's your lab. You can go and experiment there. And when you experiment, you don't have to, I mean, it's like if you go and do something wrong in the NativeScript Playground, you're not hurting anybody. It's just your lab. You can do anything you want there. And if you need any inspiration to find out what you can do with NativeScript Playground, you can always head over to market.nativescript.org, and then you'll find a lot of code samples there, which you can just click on that and choose any flavor of NativeScript that you want. You can choose NativeScript Angular, Core, or Vue, and you'll see that sample, and you can fiddle around with it and do all your experiments there. So yeah, so I recommend that you can just open API docs in one page and Playground in another page and keep trying out different APIs that are available. So that's one easy way to master NativeScript UI widgets. And then when it comes to mastering NativeScript layout containers, there are only 6 layout containers as opposed to having 19 widgets. So it should be easy, right? No, it's not. So even though you have less number of layouts, that is where most of the questions come from. Like, people ask how to properly write layouts and stuff. So I would say that the best way to start learning about NativeScript layouts is just go to nslayouts.com. You can take a picture of that as well. I'm sure some of you might have already tried it out, but if you're new to NativeScript, this is one place to go to where you can start learning about NativeScript layouts. But once you finish from there, there are some good videos on YouTube. There's one by me as well called Understanding NativeScript Layouts, which is like a 1-hour video of me going through different quirks of different NativeScript layout containers. You can watch that. And then let's get on to layouts, do's and don'ts, okay? So point number one, flatten your layouts as much as possible. If you watched a talk by Brad Martin in one of the NativeScript developer days, he went really big on this, right? He told all about flattening the NativeScript layouts as much as possible. Why? Because when you're writing layouts in NativeScript, it is not like writing divs in your HTML when you're a web developer. Layouts take a lot of resources to maintain inside your application, because they go through this measure pass and layout pass. So every time something changes in the UI, they need to go through this layout and measure pass. So the less number of layouts in your screen, the better the performance. So always try to keep your layouts as flat as possible. Next, whenever you're using a list view item template, try to keep it as light as possible, because let's say when you're developing a full UI screen, you might end up having a lot of nested layouts here and there. That's still fine. It'll be drawn once and it'll be fine. But when you're using a list view item template, it's like list can have so many number of items. So when you scroll down, there'll be more coming into the screen. So if your list view item template is a really complex item template with a lot of nested layouts, it's not going to give you the best performance. So try to use grid layout to keep your list view item templates as flat as possible. Only if you really need to have another layout in your list view item template, you can use that. But most of the time, try to keep it as light as possible. The next thing is, if you want to carry out any tasks related to knowing the dimensions of the layouts, like let's say you have some stack layout and you need to place something right in the middle and you need to know the width of the stack layout when it gets drawn on the screen or something like that. Anything that relies on knowing the dimensions of the layout, try to do it in the onNavigatedTo event. Okay, so I'll demonstrate that here. Layout measurement demo, which is just a playground app. I'm gonna scan this. You can also scan it if you want. So, QR code for those who haven't scanned. If you want to scan. Oh, wait a minute, don't scan it, because the thing that you have to see is in the log, so it doesn't matter. Let's see where you go. Yeah, so this is just a normal app. There's nothing that you can see by scanning it. But then in the page loaded event, I'm just taking a reference of this panel here. And I'm just trying to get the measured width of the panel, okay? And as you can see here, in the onNavigatingTo, which is fired before you navigate to that page, when I try to measure the height of it, it's set to zero. Even in the onLoaded event, it's set to zero. But in the onNavigatedTo, that's where you get the proper height of that layout. So anything that you want to do which relies on measurement should go into the onNavigatedTo event. Some people try to put it in the loaded event and try to put some set time out there and try to hope it works and all that. So don't try to do that. Try to do it in the proper way possible by using the onNavigatedTo event. Okay, let's get back. And then some more layout do's, because all the do's don't fit in one slide. And the next thing is, keep the paddings and margin handling constrained to the practice that your development team can follow. By this I mean that if you commonly put paddings on one type of UI widget, try to tell your teammates that, okay, this widget, we are always using this type of padding, try to follow the same thing so that it's consistent throughout your application, and that way you're trying to keep the spacing consistent throughout your entire application between iOS and Android. That way you'll get that consistent layout. And also use grid layout when you want to layer multiple widgets. So some developers might not know this, but grid layout can be used to layer items. I'd even written a blog article on that. You can check it out at shiv19.com. You can simply, it's just the way grid layout works is anything you put in the grid layout at the end will go to the top. So if there are two items sharing the same row and column, then the item that was put at the bottom will take the top area. So this technique can be used to layer multiple items and even cause some kind of overflow effects where like one there could be some layout and then there could be a profile image picking up from there. All this kind of UI can be achieved using grid layout. So use that. And another advice is to prepare as much as data as possible before binding to the view. Don't do a lot of ternary operators in your view bindings. Try to do all that in your JS side and then just bind that one variable to your view whenever possible. By avoiding that, you're improving the performance of your UI. And next, let's get to layout don'ts. Don't use layout just to create a separator line. Most of the time in your UI, you might have some lines to separate different sections of the UI. I've seen some people just use a stack layout and put a width 100% and height to 1 and then put class HR light or something like that. You don't have to use a layout just for that. You can use a simple label. Just create a label and put the class of HR light or HR dark, whichever you want, and you'll get a separator. So labels are labels don't require the same amount of resources to draw as a layout. Like I said, layouts need to go through all that measure and layout pass. So just use the lighter variant for that. Most of the time, if I want to cover some empty spaces with something, I usually use labels for that because it's easier to do with that. And I've also seen some developers use just a single layout, and then there'll be just one layout inside it. There'll be like stack layout, and inside that there'll be only one stack layout. And they're using this outer stack layout just to create some padding around the inner stack layout. Don't do that. You can do that on the web, because like you can have any number of divs and everything works there, but in NativeScript, try to avoid doing that. If you really want some kind of padding like that, you can just use the padding or margin just the way it is intended to be used. Don't use like single nested layouts. And then this might be contrary to what other people might say, but grid layout may not be the best option for all the layouts, so choose your layouts wisely. So like I said, just go to the NativeScript playground, play around with different layouts, and like I said, you can also watch that video that I made on YouTube, which has a lot of quirks of different layouts. Each layout has its own plus and minus. If just one layout could do everything, then we could have just had one layout, right? Why do we have six layouts? Because each of them solve a different problem. So use your layouts wisely, just play around with different kind of layouts. Every developer might have a different way of solving different problems. So yeah. Try learning from different code samples on the marketplace. More layout don'ts, because even the don'ts don't fit in one slide. Never place a scroll view or a list view inside stack layout. Let them breathe. These days, like in the latest version of NativeScript, if you try to do this, you'll even get a warning in your console. Some people might have noticed it. So if you have a stack layout and put a scroll view inside it, stack layout does not tell the scroll view that you have this much space available, take all of it. So it doesn't really work properly. Instead of that, you can use a grid layout and set the height to star so that it takes as much space as it needs to. So that is a better way to do it. Never put it inside a stack layout. And then use percentage instead of fixed numbers to set the dimensions of your layout. So if you try to do it with, like let's say you'll say that some particular widget takes up 100 height, then it might not look the same in all UI screen sizes. So try to use percentages. Try to say that this UI widget should take 40% of the available space. So that way you're kind of getting a scalable layout, so it should look almost the same on different screen sizes. So try to use percentages when it comes to setting the dimensions whenever possible. And this is for folks who use Angular. So if you use ngif to show or hide some part of the UI, that means every time that condition is satisfied or like it is not satisfied, that view is completely removed from the layout and then it has to be put back again. So keep in mind that every time this happens, it has to go through that on measure and on layout pass. So instead of that, you can use the visibility property so that it only has to go through that process once, and then it's just showing or hiding that item which is already there in the layout. So use that ngif only if you absolutely have to. And the same thing for ngfor, or using repeater when using NativeScript core. Try to not use repeaters as a replacement for list view, because it's not. Because list views does a lot of optimizations in terms of recycling the view so that only the amount of widgets that needs to be shown on the screen are used, and if there are like let's say 1,000 items in the list, then all thousands are not rendered at the same time. But if you try to use ngfor to do the same thing, you can try it out if you want in playground. If you create a ngfor kind of list view, and if you try to load like 1,000 items or something, then it's actually going to crash your app or slow it down or something. But if you do the same thing with a list view or a rand list view, you won't face any problem. Sometimes I've seen that developers use ngfor to create a horizontal scrollable list of cards. You can do the same thing with rad list view. So you can set the list view layout to linear list view layout and set the scroll direction to horizontal. You can't make a horizontally scrolling list using the regular NativeScript list view. You'll have to use a rad list view for that. So yeah, be careful when using repeater. If you have a very less number of items that you want to repeat, you can use ng4 or a repeater. Should be fine. Next thing to master NativeScript UI is to learn themes. So NativeScript people have made us 13 themes that we can use in our app. I'm sure not all of them will fit your organization's layout styles, but then even if you don't use the themes, you can still use all the classes that come with it. For example, if you use the NativeScript Core Light or Core Dark theme, then let's go to this page here. You can go to this page in the docs, and you can look at the various classes that are available. For example, like there is H1 to H6 just for the headings, and like the paddings and margins, like, let's go back. Yeah, paddings and margins, like you can do M0 for setting margin 0, MT0 for margin top 0, MT20 for margin top 20, and so on, with all those numbers available, 0, 2, 5, 10, 15, and so on, up to 30. And these kind of things are really useful when you're building UI fast. You don't have to write a lot of CSS, just slap on these classes, and it's gonna work fine, all right? So again, for the dividers, this is contrary to what I said, right? We need to fix that docs. It's a stack layout, HR light. It should have been a label, right? Okay, so yeah, there are so many classes available here. Just go through them so that they're in your arsenal and you can just add those classes instead of writing CSS whenever you want those styles. And also don't forget the icon fonts. Did you know that if you use Fontawesome 5, then you don't need to install any NGX font icon plugin or anything, or use any pipe or something. For example, if you want Chevron right, which is just a angular bracket that looks to the right, you can just write Chevron right in your label text field and put the class of Fontawesome 5. Then you get the Chevron right. You don't have to use the Unicode. So the Fontawesome TTF file that comes with NativeScript default template is an older version of Fontawesome that doesn't allow you to do this. But the newer version, the Fontawesome 5, lets you do something like this. So I'll share a link to one of my repositories which has the TTF file of that, because when you download the TTF file, when you download the Fontawesome 5, it doesn't come with a TTF file. I had to convert that, but I'm going to share that with you. Fontawesome's font icons are really good. And then there are animations. So next thing that you want to learn when you want to master NativeScript UI is animations. So to do this, the best two places to go to is go to the animation docs and also go to the animation example docs, where you can learn various ways to animate your UI. If you want to animate using keyframes, then you can control, like, at 50% of the time do this, at 80% of the time do that. For that kind of situations, I recommend using keyframe animations with your CSS. But for all other types of animation, I recommend you do it using code so that you have more control. You can take a look at the animation set and animation APIs with which you can compose your animation. You can use, like, you can write down multiple animations and then you can play at one time, and you can check if the animation is playing and then you can stop that. All that, you can just go to that link and try it out. And then there's one useful plugin by Alex Ziskin. He's gonna be the next speaker here, called NativeScript Effects, which you can just install and then it'll be available on all your views, and you can just do name of the view dot fade in, fade out, fade to, fade toggle, float in, float out, and so much more. So that's a nice, easy way to start making animations in your application. Just use the NativeScript FX plugin. Another animation plugin is NativeScript Lottie, with which you can use animations that are pre-baked. That means it was built using Adobe After Effects, and that was built by Brad Martin. And here's some picture of what kind of animations you can get. But here, there are some downsides. Like, if you have a designer who works with Adobe After Effects, then you can have the type of design that you want. Otherwise, you're most likely not gonna get the type of animation that you're looking for. But if you go to lottiefiles.com, you can search for the available animations. There are some animations that are free to download. You can use that. And then here's an example of Lottie animations combined with NativeScript. So this is a Bluetooth connection page that we have designed in New Zealand at Bevy. So let's play that. Okay, that is just a chart. We are just using a web view to create a chart. And then when the temperature goes up, it goes like that. So when you add animations, you can see how the UI looks much better. But then keep in mind about one thing: when you use animations in NativeScript, it is limited to whether that user is using animations or not. Like for example, in Android, you can go to the developer settings and set your animation scale to zero. If you do that, then none of your animations will play. So be wary of that, because when I was using animations, I had set my animation scale to 0.5, and I was developing with just that, and I had kept all my times to a little larger number, and when I was trying it on iOS, it was looking very slow. And I was like, oh no, what is this? Why is it feeling different on iOS and Android? And I even created a GitHub issue for that, and later I realized that, oh, it's to do with animation scale, so be wary of that. And another thing I would like to share is, if you go to your developer settings on your Android device, and if you go to the drawing section and click on Show Layout Bounds, then you can see how the layout is drawn for any app in your phone. So you can go, like you can see the layout bounds for anything, and that can be pretty useful in debugging layouts. So this one, this is a good technique to debug layouts. You can use that. And yep, that's all the things that I wanted to share. You can go to NativeScript useful links GitHub repository to get some useful links that I maintain, and you can tweet me or you can send a mail to me, and I hope you got some benefit out of this. Thank you.